On today's episode of Denver Parks and Public Spaces, we're going to take you to two very different locations in downtown Denver. First, we'll take you over to the Uptown neighborhood, where we'll visit Benedict Fountain Park. Next, we'll head down to Colfax and Josephine, where you'll see the brand new Carla Madison Rec Center that was just completed earlier in 2018. Benedict Fountain Park and the Carla Madison Rec Center were selected for this particular episode because both locations provide very unique opportunities for the public to engage in physical activity and a healthy lifestyle. In this episode, we'll explore the various ways that these two public spaces are used by members of the downtown Denver community. By engaging in candid and authentic conversations with users of the park, we were able to get a wonderful picture of how community members and visitors use the park and what they enjoy doing in it. Let's get started and let's head up to East 20th Avenue between Grant and Pennsylvania to check out Benedict Fountain Park. Described as grassy space with city views on Google Maps, Benedict Fountain Park, located in the Uptown neighborhood, is in a very unique location. Bordered by apartment homes as well as local businesses, historic-looking homes, and a school and a church, the park provides ample opportunities for people of all ages and abilities. This park provides opportunities for physical activity because it's located in a neighborhood, making it convenient for people to walk or ride their bike to. The park also has ample bicycle parking, as well as a Denver Bike Share B-cycle station, and also has enough playground equipment and open space for kids and adults to run, jump, and play. Comments on Yelp and other internet sites will often tell you that the park is filled with drug paraphernalia, persons who are experiencing homelessness, fights, and gang activity. But we decided to take a trip to the park and see for ourselves.
In the park, well said. I don't know. It was like one of the East Villages.
No.
Okay.
I was here with
no video, man. Sure.
I came over here.
It's conveniently placed. I mean, my cousin lives not that far from here, maybe about 800 meters from here. So it's convenient to come to the park every now and then. I don't know. I think it's a nice place. I mean, hopefully people are picking up the dog, you know, poo that is going on here. I think I almost stepped in one passing through the grass. So other than that, that's typical park behavior, though. So I have good experience here so far, you know.
Just because of, like, you know, like the drug paraphernalia, and then, like, my small kids, like, cigarette butts, everything everywhere, and then also like the fighting, especially during the summers, there's a lot of people that, like, there's not really ever tables, like, available, and then there's fighting, you can tell people are, like, on drugs or they're on something, and then they're also, like, drinking, and it's kind of, like, not a good vibe sometimes.
I frequent this park all the time, I'd say. I mean, as its history, I don't know much about it, but as for living in these apartments at Oakland Square, it's a great park. I mean, I see a lot of the elementary kids coming out here for their, you know, after school, like, meals. I mean, a lot of people walk their dogs here, and obviously it's a great, I mean, historical, from what I see, that people have been coming here for a while. I mean, I don't really see anything crazy about it or anything. I mean, it has its days and whatnot, but I think it's a great park. Like, I would say, obviously, all the new development and people coming and seeing the historical part of it, and, you know, obviously the people that have been here for a while are, like, what's going on, you know, like, what, you know, and their regular, their routines, I guess, would change as, like, change happens. And people don't like change sometimes, but for the most part, I think it's okay. And, you know, they could branch out elsewhere. But, I mean, those people, I mean, people still chill, and, like, they don't seem to mind at all. From what I see, obviously, police are coming around because of the change, and they want to keep it safe, but I think it's okay.
Two small kids, 8 and 11, and so we've come here a few times to play in the park. The play area, the play structures are pretty nice. There is an element that, you know, people that hang out here have a sketchy element to them, but nobody's ever really bothered us, so it's not any big deal. It might be off-putting to some people, especially bringing their kids, but for the most part, they're just hanging out, so it's not a big deal. It's kind of a weird park in that there's a lot of busy streets around all of it. But, you know, it's a pretty big, open, wide open space, so nice. So if people are just hanging out, that's fine. I don't mind. But sometimes, you know, you can smell pot smoking or there's altercations. I've heard of altercations. Not when I've had my kids with me, but when I walk by. Or, loud music, sometimes loud music, like, you know, music is great, I love music, but I don't want to have it blasting when we're just trying to relax in the park, so it's not like I've ever been, like, approached or bothered, but, yeah, it's just sometimes I have to explain, okay, they're just doing their thing to my kids, and they're not going to bother you, don't worry about it, but, yeah. So you always run into that fine line of if somebody's not doing anything bad, it's a public park. It should be free to everybody to spend time and enjoy. But then you run that fine line. If somebody's like, if there's like arguing and they're swearing and loudly, then yeah, I don't really want my kids to be like feeling all weirded out by that. So I don't know. You can't, it's hard to police that kind of thing because I don't believe there's any laws about you can't like argue with somebody else loudly, but it's still, it's like an uncomfortable mood that can permeate your time spent at the park. So I don't know. I don't know that there's any answer. So I have to admit, when you bring this up, yeah, there are so many parks that if I have to choose one to go to with my kids, I might not choose this one because of that. There have been times when we've happened by and I'm like, oh, here, we're at the park, and they want to, you know, come out and play. So I'm like, okay. But maybe this wouldn't be, like, my first choice because you don't know if there's going to be some weird elements or activities going on.
The new Carla Madison Rec Center along Colfax Avenue is a grand success of public services. The new facility is easy to access, affordable, and of the highest quality. For $15 a month or $5 a visit, working age community members gain access to a health facility that boasts excellent equipment and diversified programming. Furthermore, the form of the building's interior spaces frame views of essential elements of the Denver experience. Pedestrians, cyclists, transit riders, and those who parked at the rear of the facility are included in this human gallery. Passersby not entering the facility are from all walks of life, including many high school students walking to and from East High, and bus riders of the 15 and 15L, one of Denver's busiest routes. Several spaces surrounding the building were being actively used by groups. The dog park is the corner's most effective forum, where strangers come together and socialize with shared attention upon an active interest. These spaces are already creating important links between the rec center and Josephine Avenue. We spoke to several people to better understand how this place is being experienced. Most remarked with thanks for the building and its role in the community. The rec center was still a fresh experience for everyone, as it had only opened a month prior. People's reactions to the form and function of the place, including its grounds and connections to adjacent parts of the pedestrian public realm, were therefore freshly made impressions.
Yeah,
What do you think of this place in general? Is this like a new thing?
It's about time.
Yeah?
It's about time, man. It's about time. I mean, there's nothing. They closed too many rec centers around here. This used to be a gas station here, and behind here used to be a Safeway for a long time. So it's just good to see something that's not a liquor store or a rent-a-center. Something that's proactive here. This is the heart. This is the heart of Denver right here. This is the heart of Denver. We got to keep it alive. Things are getting scrubbed. We're losing Denver. Right now, we're losing Denver very, very fast right now. So if I were you guys, I'd take as many pictures as you can of Denver right now because it's being scraped off phenomenally block by block. Where I live, up on Sunnyside, it takes them one day, a day and a half to get rid of a house. It takes them 2 hours to get rid of a tree. And literally, we're losing Denver right now. It's happening. It's good. It's new. It's new. It's refreshing. At least there's some glass and some lights on it. It's not a big box. I'm surrounded by boxes. Pretty soon there's going to be nothing but 4-story on the corner, 3-story in the middle, no sunlight at all. So I think it's spacious. I think it gives a lot of space. I think the thing about it is, the thing we have here is there's big monuments here. And they all need space. This place gets very crowded. This is actually where the People's Fair started at East High School way back in the days. And it started from a block party from the neighborhood here. That's how cool these people are around here. East wouldn't be East if it wasn't for the parents out here and the people who give the money and the community. It's the community. It's you and it's me that really make this happen. Oh, yeah. That's it.
I think it's cool.
Yeah, I like the basketball facility because it's kind of intertwined with the gym. So it's like you can do both.
What do you think of Colfax in general?
I think it's some parts are sort of scary. Yeah.
Do you think this part's scary?
No.
Yeah, we live in Lowry. And we actually live within walking distance of Montclair Rec Center.
Okay.
And we go there on a fairly regular basis. But we definitely wanted to check out the new rec center here.
As just an alternative? Or have you heard something?
I mean, like I said, we could have just walked over there and did the same old thing.
Yeah.
But I kind of wanted to get them out of Lowry and check out the new rec center.
So we've heard that there's a farmer's market here during the summer. Have you guys ever been to the farmer's market here?
Yeah, we have been to the farmer's market here.
So, I don't come up here very often. I go to East right there. But I think it kind of just like cleaned the place up a little bit, made it like nicer, and helped the neighborhood out.
Do a lot of East students come over here?
Oh yes, like during lunch and after school. And it's nice, it gives them something to do rather than hang out in front of the school all the time.
Are the students hanging out in the rec center or in this space right here?
Both. There's some people that'll use like the rock wall or some people that'll go and play basketball or just hang out.
Down the middle drops one more grain of sand. They say that new life makes losing life easier to understand. And words are kind, they help ease the mind. I miss my old friend. And though you got